Hello everyone and welcome to a thoroughly modified Nissan Xterra which replaces its boxy and rugged predecessor. And in today's detailed review video, we'll also find out if it meets the criteria for being a basic off-roader. But before we move forward, please consider subscribing to my channel by clicking that subscription button, red one, yes, and make sure to leave all the notifications on by clicking that bell icon so that you never miss any video updates from my channel. So the new Nissan Xterra is offered in three different versions, which is your SE, Titanium and the Platinum versions. And also the SE and the Titanium is offered in two different drive options, which is your rear wheel drive only and the four wheel drive options, while the model I am testing is the Platinum version of the Xterra, which comes with only the four wheel drive system. And also, I'm going to be explaining the differences between the Platinum and the Titanium because the two models are really very, very close, apart from, you know, a few interior changes and the very minute exterior changes. So that I will be explaining as and when there are any differences. But otherwise, if I don't mention anything, that means everything is pretty much similar between the Titanium and the Platinum. So let's start with the front. So you get this V-Motion grille out here, which is the chromed one, and then horizontal slots out here with the Nissan badging, which is again chromed, and then there's this plate out here which is for the radar. So yeah, if there is like for the safety system, the driver assistance, all of that is controlled using this sensor which has been given out here. At the bottom you would notice this silver color skid plate which has been given. So this car has a approach angle of 32.3 degrees, which is quite decent that way, and it's got quite a bit of height also. So yeah, at the bottom you can notice, like, you know, there is like a sloping when you look at it from the side. And out here you would notice there's more chrome, you know, surround around this plastic bit of trim which has this honeycomb sort of design, just the plastic gloss one. Yeah, it's not a vent or anything. And at the bottom you would notice the LED fog lights which have been given, and on top you get a mixture of LED and halogen cluster. So there are also DRLs on top, and on the sides you would find the turn signals, and the main headlight cluster is LED, which is like made up of these four, you know, huge LED lights. So when you look at the Xterra from the front, you may nearly, you know, mistake it for, you know, being a petrol, because yeah, from your rear mirror you would actually think that this is a petrol. So when you look at the new Xterra from the sides, you would notice that quite a bit of changes have been, you know, made on this one. Firstly, you know, those boxy arches have gone, and now you have more, you know, roundish one out here, and even in the back there are more, you know, arches on top and out here at the bottom also. So yeah, the boxy ones is all replaced with all these, you know, subtle lines and curves out here. And out here on this Platinum version you get 18 inch alloy rims, while in the Titanium versions you get the 17 inch, and even on the lower ones you get the 17 ones, but only on the Platinum you get 18 inch alloy rims. And you get double wishbone setup in the front, and the side mirrors are chromed ones, and they also have the turn signals inside them, LED ones, and these are power foldable. They are also power adjustable. They also have the blind spot warning inside them. Then they also have one of the cameras from the 360 degree camera system. There is also this chrome colored black plastic trim which is given. Yeah, this is again like a honeycomb structure, but yeah, it's just the fake mesh grill which has been covered out here. There's also this sideboard which has been given, but it's a fixed one, so yeah, it doesn't move. These door handles are chromed ones in the front and also in the back, while the front door handles are smart keyless entry door handles. You also get the silver roof rails on top, as I mentioned, more arches. And the thing is that when you put this car in the two-wheel drive mode, so only the rear wheels are powered, while when you put it in the four-wheel drive, obviously all four wheels are going to be powered, but it's predominantly like the rear wheel drive when you choose the two-wheel drive option. Now in the rear you get redesigned tail light cluster, which is a combination of LED and halogen. So you get like halogen turn signals, while the rest of the bits is all LED. So even out here the boxiness has gone away, and then you get more, you know, curvy sort of design in the back with this chrome thick one, like, you know, like a handle on top. Yeah, looks like that. And then Xterra out here in chrome, Nissan badging, and then the Platinum. So if you have the Titanium plank will be given out here again in the chromed version. At the bottom you would find this silver again skid plate for the back. So you get a departure angle of 26.6 degrees on this Xterra, while the spare wheel has been mounted underneath the car and not inside the boot, so you have to access it from inside inside, but yeah, you have to lower the spare wheel. Now when it comes to the visibility, it's actually decent in terms of, you know, the view that you get. There are some pillars that hinder, but if you have passengers, then yeah, your visibility may get blocked. But on this platinum version of the Xterra, you have this camera which feeds the rear view mirror, and that rear view mirror is a smart rear view mirror. So you flick it and then you get to view the digital feed from this camera system. So yeah, that's really convenient when you have a lot of people inside. Now this is only platinum option that you get this the smart rear view camera, while on the titanium ones you just get the auto dimming feature. So in terms of the settings, you can do a lot more in that view from that smart view camera. So you can, you know, change the brightness, you can change the angle of it, you can change the direction of it, you can also change the brightness of it. So you can do a lot more stuff inside that. And also not just that, so you can just flick it and then you can, you know, switch it on. But the thing is, the feed from that is a little grainy, like, and during a bright daylight it seems a little washed out also. But yeah, I don't know, it's still a good feature to have, you know, when you have a lot of passengers sitting, you know, in both the second and the third row of seat. When it comes to the boot space, so in this current setting there is decent amount of you know, boot space, although there is no mention about in liters how much boot space there is. But you can put two medium sized bags in the bag. There is also this sort of partition, or like, you know, a box which has been given. So yeah, you can remove that and get extra bit of storage out here. But that is, it's got a purpose out here, and that is some days when you are going to be lowering the third row of seats, so it makes the floor flatter. There are also scruff plates out here so that you don't damage your bumper. More tying points out here for when you put any luggage and you want to tie it down. Now in order to fold down these third row of seat, there are straps given at the bottom, so you just have to pull them and these seats easily fold down. Yeah, quite easy. And then now you have a flat floor out here, which is why now this, you know, this box or whatever you call it, the floor that has been raised, now it makes sense because it gives you a, you know, flatter loading area. But again, I don't know how much in liters, but you can easily put two big bags and, you know, some more small bags on the top. Why, even the opening is quite, you know, nice and even. But yeah, putting your luggage in and out is going to be quite easy because yeah, there's literally, like, you know, you get this flat floor because of which you can remove the luggage easily. Now in order to fold down the second row of seat, you have to go in the front and do that. There are no levers or anything, so when I do that, let me just, so there are like levers given out here, you just pull them and then you can fold these seats down. I'll do it from the other side. Now when I do that, there is quite a bit of space, but the thing is, now you feel like, you know, the boot space has been raised up because of these seats, you know, really being padded. But again, there is no mention of the amount of liters that you can put. But in the most sensible journalistic way, I'll show you by going inside. Oh, my head is already hitting the roof. Yeah, so it's a flat floor, so you can go quite a lot inside, and then you can stuff like a lot of things now. But yeah, as I said, the seats are a little raised up, which is why you would feel that, you know, there is like slight lesser luggage storage. Now since this Xterra is offered as a basic off-roading SUV, there are some things which are economical inside the interior also, mainly, you know, the material choice and the quality of it. So you get, you know, plastic dashboard out here, even out here on the sides, all plastic. The door cards are also plastic, and they all come in like one color with this, you know, silver color trim which has been given, the glossy one. But yeah, pretty much wherever you touch there is plastic. At the bottom there is this carpet lining halfway through. So yeah, but not just that, there are also some places where the quality is a little dodgy. So for example, this panel that, you know, keeps moving around, there is this selector for your four-wheel drive and two-wheel drive, you know, that thing. Yeah, panel also keeps moving around. Even this AC, you know, dial and the whole area, yeah, that also keeps moving around. And not just that, even this center, you know, armrest, the whole center, you know, this tunnel, that also, yeah, keeps vibrating. But yeah, it's just a little loose. Yeah, they, I'm sure, can, you know, control this quality and, you know, get back everything in place and, you know, tight that way. But yeah, Most of it is plastic because, as I mentioned, it's offered as a basic off-roading SUV. So yeah, most this is all given for the fact that, you know, it's more rugged and, you know, rough and tough. Now, when it comes to the driver's information display, you get two dials on both the sides. One is for your, you know, the speedometer, and one is the rev counter on the left side. And in the center, there is a 7-inch TFT screen. Now, that screen actually shows you a lot of, you know, basic information. It shows you decent information, but yeah, it's quite plain and simple. So, you know, you can see your digital speed, you can see your fuel economy, you can reset it also. Then there is the Bluetooth audio option. You can go inside and change from EM/FM, and the rear display which has been given on this Xterra. Then you can go into the safety systems. You can go inside and check, you know, the driver assistance via your lane, blind spot, emergency braking and all of that. And then last option is your setting, in which you will find pretty much every single information for your driver assistance, your eco mode settings, tire pressure, the various, you know, vehicle settings, finer ones inside are all given out here. But yeah, it gets a little washed out, you know, in a bright daylight, especially when the sun is falling directly on the cluster. That time, yeah, you may find the information, you know, a little blurred out. But yeah, most of the times it works really fine, and I like the fact that, you know, it's just basic and you can, you know, work your way around quite easily. So when it comes to this steering wheel, this is a leather covered steering wheel. Now, this is again a part of the platinum option, which is what you get on this one, which is a leather covered steering wheel. And this steering wheel is just, you know, tiltable. That's it. There is no telescopic adjustment, so you can just tilt it and, you know, put it in the right position, set it up. And on your right side, you would find the controls for your standard cruise control system and also the communication controls, while on the left side you would find the controls for your media and the infotainment, and also the buttons to control the driver's information display that you see in the center. So yeah, that's pretty much, you know, the steering wheel design for you, like with the Nissan badging in the center. Now, when it comes to the air conditioning controls, again, straightforward button operated system has been given. But on this Nissan Xterra, it's kind of a tri-zone air conditioning system. So dual zone in the front for the driver and the passenger. And there is a dial which has been given on the roof for the second and the third row of passenger. So the vents are also mounted on the roof itself, and also the dial. So you can control the fan speed from there, while the rear air conditioning can be switched on from here, where there is like a button which has been given. So only when you switch this on, the passengers in the back can use their air conditioning control. Otherwise, yeah, they can't. So you have a lot of control in the front. In terms of the actual air conditioning controls, there is very straightforward, you know, buttons given out here. So there is an on off button, you switch it on, and then there is the fan speed, you can control the fan, and then dials on both the sides to control the temperature for the driver and the passenger, and some more buttons to adjust the flow of air and everything. So yeah, very easy. Yeah, considering that, you know, families are going to use this air conditioning system, which is why it's made very simple and straightforward. Now, when it comes to this infotainment system, this is a 9-inch newly introduced infotainment system on this Xterra. So on the titanium version, you get an 8-inch infotainment system, while on this you get the platinum version, you get the 9-inch infotainment screen. And the screen is pretty nice and bright, and it's crisp also. And it's a glossy one with, you know, this, and it fits really well into the dashboard. Like, you know, there is no odd bit where, you know, the screen is hanging or sticking out from here. So yeah, it's a very straightforward, you know, into the dashboard, very flushed out. So there are also dials given on both the sides for your volume and the scroller, so you can scroll through the menus. Now, the main menu option consists of your screen in the middle, where you will see your media controls and also the go home, like a shortcut button for your navigation. And then when you swipe onto the right side, you will find your controls for your the radio controls, which is the AM/FM. Then there is the Bluetooth audio. So in terms of the connectivity, you can connect to this infotainment system using the Bluetooth, USB, and for some weird reason there's only wireless Apple CarPlay, but the Android Auto is wired. So yeah, you have to use a wire to connect to that. And then there is the options for your navigation at the bottom. And when you scroll more, you will come to a clock and then also a shortcut, you know, page of like widgets which are given on your screen itself. So you can customize those widgets and you can arrange the icons that you see on the screen, or you can add more options or whatever you want to do. Then there are also shortcut features given at the bottom for your phone. You can go directly into that. Then there is the information, which is your vehicle information where you are, so you can go into the notifications, you can go into the vehicle, you can get your report, then you can where am I, it will show you the coordinates, then your GPS positioning, then the system information, all of that you can see from here. Then the audio options for your connectivity and everything, then the USB if you connected any USB device, Apple CarPlay, then there is the more finer settings option in which you can change pretty much everything from your connections to your phone, navigation, sound, volume and beeps, clock, custom, every single thing. I'm also going to be doing a detailed, you know, video on how to use this infotainment system, which will be dropping after this video. So make sure to check that out too. So there are also buttons given at the bottom for your brightness of the screen, the track changer, audio menu, map, camera. You can even call the camera system if you want to at any point of time, like the 360 degree camera system, you can do that. No, but not while you're driving. Yeah, you can't do that. Then you come to the main menu. The menu button is given in the center, so while driving it's just more easier to, you know, control this screen. So the screen that way is slightly slow to my liking when you scroll it around, but it's still very simplified, you know, and straightforward, laid down all the menu options. Yeah, and once you connect the Apple CarPlay or the Android Auto, yeah, you're pretty much going to be in that screen. So at that point of time, it's pretty snappy that way. Now when it comes to the charging, you have two USB ports in the front, which is your one normal USB port and one type C USB port. There's also a 12 volt power socket which has been given. There's also a wireless charger which has been given. You have a button for that, you have to press that, where there's also the extra badging which has been given out there. And there is one more USB port which is given in the third row of passenger, and that is pretty much it. But for the second row, there is nothing that has been given. Now there are buttons given out here for your hill ascent and descent control. You can switch it on, and also the differential lock button which has been given. There are two more buttons which are given out here, which are for your second row folding seat option. So it's a quick folding seat option. So if you want the passengers to get into the third row, then you can just, you know, pull the switches and the seats would automatically fold and, you know, give way to the passengers for entering into that third row, which is really, you know, neat feature, and it's like really easy and quick. Now when it comes to the storage, you can put 1 to 1.5 liter worth of bottle in the door cards and some more storage on the side. There is also this charging pad where you can even put your phone or wallet. There are also two cup holders out here, but they are just the standard size, not the flexible cup holders. Then there is this very small storage out here in which you can put your phones and wallets. And the thing is, this hand rest out here is, it's got the soft touch, no doubt, or leather covered soft touch material, but it's like quite short that way when you're driving. So yeah, your arm is literally like, you know, hanging out here because of, you know, this hand rest being a little shorter, because when you place it, yeah, you can't really, you know, as you can see, reach out to this the gear shifter. So there is also this glove box which is given out here, like plastic one from inside, and that is pretty much it in the front. While in the second row of seat in the door cards, you can again put like 1 to 1.5 liter worth of bottle, and then there are also two cup holders given in the center armrest. Now there are grab handles which are given in the front for the passenger and also for the second row of passenger in the pillars, while there is no sunroof which is offered across any Xterra models. But there is also an SOS button which has been given, which is like an emergency button, which when you meet any accident or there is any fatalities in the car or anyone's having any medical emergency, you can press that button and you can, you know, connect to someone, and then they will help you find, you know, a medical help or send something across to you while, you know, locating your GPS coordinates. Now on this platinum version, you get leather seats, while on the titanium models and the lower ones, you get the fabric seat options. And the seats are black colored leather seats with the perforated design, but this is just for the design purpose. They are not the heated or the cooled seats, and the seats offer really good comfort, you know, during longer drives. They are quite broad that ways, and they are also soft. Even the backrest is pretty soft. They have this side shoulders to, you know, support you, but not like, you know, the thick ones, but very gradual one. So yeah, during longer journeys it's pretty, you know, comfortable. But the only thing is, you sit quite high up and these seats actually don't go down, so at every point you really feel like, you know, you are driving a, you know, very big SUV, because you are constantly, you know, sitting right like quite up that ways. Now the driver side seat is 10-way electronically adjustable, including the 2-way lumbar control, while the passenger side seat is only manually adjustable. Now, when you sit in the second row of seat of this Xterra, you are actually sitting quite high up, and you would notice this immediately because I can see like the front two seats are really low while I am sitting quite high up, and also you can see it from the angle, you know, my legs are making like there's a fair bit of angle that way because the seats are like flat and then you know that way is quite low, but it's just that the whole floor is raised up, which is why it gives you that feeling. And there is like decent amount of knee room out here. This seat is in my driving position, but yeah, there is seat. These seats are also curved out here, and also headroom is just about decent, like someone about 6 feet may start brushing their head against the ceiling. Yeah, because it's, yeah, it's a little tighter that way in terms of the head space. You can also slide your legs under the seats, but there is not much of a room underneath the seats. So yeah, you during the longer journeys, yeah, most of the times you are going to be sitting like this. This is going to be your position. There's also no tunnel out here, like a very subtle small one out here, but it's still the flat one, so when you sit in the middle it's still going to be quite comfortable, although it's just the same amount of, you know, headroom that you get when you sit in the middle seat as well. There are two vents which are given out here, which are controlled from the front from the front air conditioning control, while there is this air conditioning other unit which is given on the roof with the dial and vents out here in the second row and also the third row of seat. While in terms of the quality of the material out here in the door cards, you would find the plastic ones, which we found the same one in the front, and you can put like 1.5 liter water bottle, and that is pretty much about it. There's no more storage in the door cards. There's also a handrest which has been given, and it's a little tiny one, and this also has two cup holders, but they are not the flexible ones but just the standard cup holders. But yeah, and it's a little, you know, shorter also in terms of the length, but I get it because yeah, otherwise then, you know, this would block the view of the rear view for the driver, which is why it has been given a smaller one. While this rear seat also can be slided, so you can give extra, you know, room for the third row of passenger if, yeah, you know, there are some and they need extra bit of space, but otherwise you can utilize all the space out here. You can even recline these seats, that is an option too. So yeah, you can do both of them, and it can come in the front also. You can make it upright also, or you know, you can have it at an angle also. In the second row of seat, you would find black color leather seats which are perforated. Again, they don't do any cooling or heating, and they are also the same material quality and, you know, the softness that has been given in the front. For the second and the third row of passenger, there are optional extras in terms of the screen if you want to have in the headrest, or there is this 11 inch screen which is mounted on the roof itself, so you can drop that screen down and then you can open it, and then you can switch the screen from the front infotainment screen, where you can switch to the rear entertainment, and then the screen would, you know, open, start functioning. But the thing is, the screen is only offered in the platinum version. In the titanium version, you don't get this overhead, you know, screen. But the screen can also be controlled using this remote control. It's very simple, straightforward. You can just switch it on and off, and then you can, you know, just control the screen. In order to play something on the screen, you can connect the USB, and then you can, you know, play something out here. Or there's an HDMI cable which is for some reason given in the third row and on the side of the passenger, so there the port has been given. From there you can connect that HDMI and, you know, project something onto the screen. Now in the third row, first of all, getting in and out is really easy because the second row of seat rolled up very well, and then they give you ample of space to get in and out. Even these doors open up quite big. But when you get into the third row of seat, you are sitting quite low compared to how you were in the second row. In the second row, you were sitting quite high up. In this, you are sitting quite low to the floor. So there is literally no height to these seats. You are literally like on the floor of this, you know, Xterra. So even the floor on the sides, it's starting to curve around. So yeah, there is that, you know, little bit of reduction in the leg space also. And because you can see it from my angle, I'm sitting quite low down, and then which is why my angle, yeah, of my legs is a little, yeah, you know, awkward to say the least. And then on the sides, you would find one cup holder on either sides and some more storage, and then there is also this HDMI port and the USB port, which is the normal type A USB port which has been given out here in the third row. While the seats are black colored leather seats, but they are not perforated in design, just the plain leather seat. There are also headrests which are given for the third row of passenger, and you can even recline these seats, yeah, and you know, adjust the angle of the backrest that way. So yeah, you have a bit of, you know, room to play around. But when I put these seats up, there is just marginal amount of, you know, knee room out here, and also the headroom is still all right because yeah, someone about 6 feet will squeeze here, but yeah, would definitely start, you know, touching the roof. There are also AC vents out here, but yeah, in terms of the yeah seating positions, it's really awkward. Only when you have more than five people, then yeah, someone can sit in here, but otherwise it's just best to be, you know, avoided. So now it's time to find out the off-road capabilities of this Xterra. In order to begin with our off-roading excursion, I'll put the car in the four-wheel drive using this dial which has been given at the bottom, and you can also leave it in the auto when you're driving inside the city, but yeah, I prefer to put it in the two-wheel drive because it yeah, it's just better off that way. And then you can now put it in the four high and switch off the traction control, and now we are ready to go. While I'll also keep the car in the manual mode because it's better to have the gear controls, because that way you can use a lot of torque and power when you want to, you know, get out. So yeah, this thing can do off-roading, light bit of off-roading, not the heavy dunes or anything that it can tackle. It can do light, like what I am doing right now. So it's good for, you know, family outings where you want to go on a light bit of camping into the desert like this, where, you know, the dunes are subtle. So this Xterra comes with a ladder frame chassis. So basically there is a main chassis and then on which the body has been put on this car. So which is what? It gives you that extra bit of rigidity, and they've also formed up the chassis a little bit, which is why you will get that bit of extra, you know, hardness and stiffness from the chassis for doing the off-roading. But yeah, it's quite you know, easily doing this. But the only problem is that sometimes it would feel that, you know, it's a little underpowered, and that is due to the fact that, you know, this Xterra now comes with a 2.5 liter four-cylinder naturally aspirated petrol engine that produces 165 horsepower and 241 newton meters of torque. So yeah, that way it's quite basic in terms of, you know, the power generation, which is what it, you know, makes it feel a little underpowered in sometimes, you know, and especially when you need a power inside, you know, an off-roading, you know, surface like this. So that's where you will feel the need of that power. And also there is a centrally lockable differential which has been given, the button for which is given out here, so you can put that when you need that, you know, traction all the time. But yeah, most of the times the car is quite you know, capable of doing the figuring out what V's to power and how much to power all the time. So yeah, you don't have to bother with all that. So I think that way it's still a decent, you know, off-roader. As I mentioned, you don't really, even the suspensions are good, but yeah, the steering is something which is a bit, yeah, I'll discuss that when we come to, because there are lots of rotations that you have to perform. You get a hydraulic one, although on this off-roading surface you get nice bit of, you know, control while you are driving, because you are going to be putting a lot of force like this. Let me come in on the surface and then explain you what this car is capable of on road. Let me just put it first back into the auto and the two-wheel drive and the traction control on. So yeah, let's now begin with our normal review. So on road, this has like a 2.5 liter engine, as I mentioned, and this engine is mated to a 7-speed automatic gearbox. And the thing is, even the gearbox tends to, if you leave it on auto, even on the road sometimes, yeah, tends to shift very quickly, or, you know, sometimes it isn't able to figure out, like you saw right now. So it keeps changing you know, gears, and sometimes it just utilizes too much of RPM before changing the gears. And bear in mind, I know that, you know, when you press the throttle very, you know, aggressively, the car thinks you want to accelerate, but this is just the normal pedal that I am, you know, giving the input that way. So it's not that much, and it's still, you know, taking its own sweet time to, you know, change into that other gears quickly. So yeah, that is something which, yeah, is a little, you know, I found off when I was driving on the roads also. So that is something. And then in terms of the engine, yeah, on road it just doesn't feel that laggy, and it's quite enough that way for, you know, the car for just moving around, you know, your family. And if there are passengers inside, then yeah, it's not going to be feeling a very laggy one. You can just cruise around, yeah, easily on 120. And in terms of the efficiency from this engine, you would find anywhere between, you know, 7.5 to 8.5, at least that is what I am getting, although the claimed is 11.1. so I don't know, you maybe can get up to 10, you know, on the longer highway stretches. But yeah, if you're going to be like doing light bit of off-roading, so it's going to be somewhere around, you know, 7 to 8 kilometers per liter. So yeah, that is, and plus this car is big and also this car is heavy. It's also top heavy, which is what you feel, you know, when you are driving around. Now, when it comes to the steering wheel, the steering is a hydraulic one, and I had mentioned that, you know, there is something about the steering. So the thing is, there are lots of rotations that you have to perform on the steering wheel. It's almost close to 2 rotations that you have to perform on this wheel when you move from, you know, extreme one end to the other end. So when you move from left to right, you will be almost turning it like by 4, you know, rotations. So that's how much, you know, the turning, you know, the angle is on this steering wheel. So yeah, that is a bit of a, you know, sort of a thing. But otherwise, the steering that way is pretty responsive, and it's got a good amount of, you know, the direction to it. You get nice bit of feedback also, because this is hydraulic steering, so you get, yeah, that bit of feedback from the steering wheel and also from the wheels, what are they doing. So yeah, it's for an SUV, this is a really good steering wheel setup. Now when it comes to the suspensions, they are on the softer side, but though they are soft, they still provide you that, you know, comfortable ride for the passengers in the car. And also, there is not much of a roll actually. Like when you turn it into the corners, it's very gradual, and it just doesn't, you know, imbalance itself or anything. So there's nothing sort of that. So let me do a slalom and show you. But when you do that, yeah, that's when you realize, like, you know, the weight of the car, because then you're going from one end to the other end. Oh yeah, then you start feeling that weightiness, you know, especially the top weight for this SUV. So yeah, that is when, you know, you notice. But otherwise, yeah, it's a very comfortable setup that has been given on this Xterra. Now when it comes to the brakes, here is what, again, I am surprised. So there are 2 front disc brakes, and in the rear you get drum brakes. So I don't know, the performance is kind of all right from it, but yeah, you do feel that, you know, the front ones are the disc brake ones, because they grip, and then, you know, the car sort of lunges in the front every time you brake. So actually, let me show you by doing from 100 kilometers to 0 kilometers. Yeah, because when I accelerate, the engine is going to be a little stressed out, and you can hear these revs. So when I, yeah, you literally feel like your nose is diving down, and then, you know, you are braking it, because the back end becomes really light because of those rear drum brakes, which actually, you know, perform a weaker action compared to the disc brakes. But yeah, nonetheless, you are never going to do this. I hope you never have to do this. So if you ever do, yeah, but it's still all right. It's kind of okay. It will be able to brake itself that way. It's not going to break apart completely, so it's fine. Now when it comes to the noise and the vibrations, there is no vibrations from inside, because it's all solidly well put together and well made. So yeah, in terms of that, it's pretty good. And when it comes to the noise, there is no tire noise or road surface noise from those tires, but there's only very marginal, you know, wind whooshing that you will hear on a very, you know, windy day that way. But otherwise, though these windows are huge, yeah, they are absolutely quiet that way. The only sound that you sometimes hear is this engine, which gets really stressed out, you know, when you try to accelerate. So don't do that, you know, if you want a sudden acceleration from this, I get, like, you know, you wouldn't want anyways a sudden acceleration from this SUV. But yeah, if you do, or if you are going to be performing any overtaking maneuvers, then yeah, plan it a little ahead before doing that. Now when it comes to the safety systems on this Xterra, you will find 6 airbags, 2 for the front driver and the passenger, 2 side airbags again for the driver and the passenger, and 2 curtain airbags put in the frames on the sides. While this 6 airbags is only available in the Platinum version, while 2 airbags are available as standard across all the other model lineup, which is your Titanium and the SE lineup. So you get 2 front airbags on that one. Then there is child ISOFIX points in both the seats in the second row, and there is also tire pressure monitoring system. There is also ABS, there is also vehicle dynamic stability, then there is the traction control. Then there is also the front and the back collision warning. Then there is any alert if there is anything. Then there is the lane departure warning. There is also this SOS button which has been given. Then there is a 360 degree camera system, and the output from that is quite all right, although you cannot select different views on this 360 degree camera system. So you get on one side, you know, the rear view, and on the other side you get the 360 degree camera system. And the output from that for this car is all right. I wouldn't, you know, expect like to be the best one, but yeah, it's still pretty decent that way. You get clear images and display from on your screen. Now when it comes to the pricing of this Xterra, so the base version of this Xterra, which is the SE one, starts at 99,000 dirhams, and the titanium one comes at 108,900 dirhams, while this platinum version, which is a four-wheel drive version, comes at 133,900 dirhams. Now the thing is, for that price, I know there are lots of options available, but also this, it offers you 7-seat, you know, and then there is also a spacious cabin, there is also decent bit of, you know, tech which has been given. Now that, you know, this Xterra is advanced, you get the looks of it, pretty much the petrol, if you ever wanted to own, then yeah, this is the kind of the petrol that you can own now. And make sure, yeah, you just show it from the front, and because from the back it's pretty obvious. So yeah, from the front it's more like a petrol. So yeah, there are that way many reasons, but if you ask me, then I would just suggest that, you know, you can also get the titanium version, because the titanium version pretty much has every single thing that you want from the car, and it's for 108,000, and for that price, yeah, it's a pretty decent kit that you will get after that. But yeah, if you want to have a fully spec'd out version, you know, with all the leather seats and everything, then yeah, this is probably the option that you can consider. You can also do light bit of off-roading as well. Anyways, that is pretty much it for this video. Give this video a thumbs up and thank you for watching this video. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, then you can click here. And if you want to watch more videos, then click here. I shall see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Take care and stay safe.